the next half hour in the library with Mel, filling her in on the Lexi debacle. We then make the following list:
lies, realities, and possible solutions. Lie number one, I'm popular. Reality, I'm not. Possible solution, somehow become popular.
If you knew how to do this, if you knew how to do that, you would have already done it.
Why this solution won't work? See above comment by Mel. Line number two. I'm dating Jared Bentley. I'm dating Jared Bentley. Reality, Jared Bentley doesn't know I'm alive. He doesn't know my name. I don't think.
One time, earlier this year, he asked me if he could borrow a writing utensil in English, and all I had was this pen my grandmother had given me. And, yeah, over the summer. That was purple and said Devon in huge yellow letters.
Maybe he remembers this. Possible solution? Pretend Jared and I broke up. Why this solution won't work? Thing is, even though it's the first time I've seen Lexi, we still IM sometimes. And last night, we talked. The last time we talked was last night, when Lexi told me she had this huge surprise for me. I can't tell her. I can't tell Lexi that we broke up because last night I was acting like Jen and I were still. And if she's all, that's funny, last night you two were going out. You probably made the whole thing up and now staging a breakup so that no one thinks you're psycho. Line number three. I'm always dressed like a fashionista. Except this one isn't really a lie. More of a misconception. She just assumed that I dressed like a fashionista. Yeah. I'm more of a hoodie and jeans girl. Possible solution? Tell Lexi I've developed a rare skin disease that makes me allergic to designer clothing. It may be catching, so tell her to stay away unless she wants to give up her Prada and BCBG. Why the solution won't work? Lexi Cortland is not stupid. Bottom line, I am in deep trouble.
When I get home from school, my mom's at the kitchen table. When I get home from school, my mom's at the kitchen table on her laptop. She's a freelance web designer now, which is one of the things she and my dad agreed on this summer. Apparently, my mom was feeling suffocated by her job at the design firm where she worked, and she wanted to start her own business. My dad was worried that if she did it, we'd all be out on the street, homeless and with no food, which even I thought was a little ridiculous. Because my dad is a pharmaceutical rep, and so is Thursday Marinos, this girl in my math class. Darcy's parents have four kids. Her mom stays at home and takes care of them. The house is bigger than ours, and I don't think Darcy or her brother ever went hungry or anything. Anyway, my mom thought that since my dad worried we were all going to end up homeless, that meant he didn't believe in her abilities and wasn't encouraging her to pursue her dreams. So, she got really mad. Which led to the rift and tension in their marriage. But ever since Kate and I got back from my grandma's, my dad has seemed super supportive. I think it's because they're going to a marriage counselor, and it seems to be helping. FYI, my mom and dad make up excuses when they go to their counseling appointments. But I totally found the brochure in my mom's desk. In my mom's desk. Once, while I was looking for a red Sharpie to use for my social studies poster in Communist Russia. It's kind of ridiculous to keep a secret if you ask me. Because I'm 13, I wouldn't freak out about it or anything. But I do my best not to let it on that I know, and also to keep it a secret from Katie. Because I don't want anyone getting upset. Hey, honey.
How was school?
Good. I lie. Figured it's best not to say anything about the whole my life possibly being ruined thing. I open a cupboard and pull down a box of peanut butter and chocolate granola bars.
Hello. Oh, honey. Hello. Oh, honey. You shouldn't wear skates in the house.
Why not? I'm in training.
Well, that's great.
But you need to wear your blade guards if you're going to be walking around like that.
Katie is 5 and thinks she's an Olympian, or going to be an Olympian. Problem is, she wants to get to the Olympics, but can't decide what she wants to go to the Olympics for. So 1 week she's an ice skater, the next she's a gymnast, etc. One time she came to the dinner table wearing a tutu she had left over from ballet lessons she took when she was 3. It was way too small for her and also confusing to everyone because ballet is an Olympic sport. When we told her this, she burst into tears because ballet was her one true shot at the gold. Katie can be quite dramatic.
Mom, wearing my blade guard does not help when I'm out on the ice trying to stay balanced.
You need to wear your blade guards.
Otherwise, you're going to ruin the floor. And we'll have to spend the money we're currently using for your skating lessons to pay for a new one.
Katie is having what my grandmother called a difficult transition. Basically, since my parents pretty much gave her whatever she wanted over the summer, new bike, new skates, a balance beam so she can practice being an Olympic gymnast, and a trampoline, and my grandmother never made her do anything around the house. She's not used to people saying no to her, which is why she pushes a lot of fits.
I want some juice. Fine. Katie, honey, you can get the juice yourself. Mommy's working.
Devon, listen, your father and I are going out tonight, so you're going to have to watch Katie.
No, thanks. I don't want Devon to watch me.
It'll be fun, Katie.
How come?
It just will.
How long do I have to babysit for?
Just a few hours. We're going out to dinner.
Ring, ring, ring. Ugh!
I got it.
Hello? Debbie, it's Lexi.
Oh. Hi.
You weren't online.
Sorry, I just got home.
So check it. I was thinking we could go together tonight.
Get together?
No, go together.
To the mall?
With Jared and Kim and everyone?
Oh. Great. Just dandy. Listen, Lexi,
my mom can drive if your mom can pick us up.
Oh. I can't. I have to babysit for Katie. Hey, wait. How did you get invited?
After I finished with Mr. Boone, I went back to the cafeteria. Kim invited me.
doesn't. I say, deciding, now was the time to tell Lexi the truth. But what do I say exactly? Choice A, Lexi, I'm not popular. I'm a total liar. Jared Bentley doesn't even know I'm alive. Choice B, gotta go. Lexi, talk to you, or never. Then avoid Lexi at school forever. Or choice C, Lexi, I have to confess something. You see, I'm really not going out with Jared, and I'm really not that popular. I don't know why I told you that all that stuff this summer, and I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to lie to you. Choice B seemed like the most logical solution, but the problem, besides, of course, the fact that I could end up a social outcast, is that I really do want to be friends with Lexi. Listen! Lexi, it's really important that you don't say anything to anyone about me and Jared dating. How come? Because Mel has a crush on him, so our relationship is totally secret. Got it? Lexi, you got that? Mel? Your friend, Mel? Yeah. Mel has a, Mel has a crush on Jared, and, she would kill me if she found out, we were dating. So, you can't tell anyone. Who knows? Just me and you. So you have to keep it a secret. Debbie, I won't. I wish you had told me about this earlier, though. I mean, I could have slept at school today. You didn't, though, right? You didn't tell anyone about Jared and me. I don't think so. Well, that's good. Listen, I'm probably going to break up with him soon. Anyway, the guilt is killing me. Oh, Debbie, you're such a good friend. I mean, I'm sure Melissa's nice and everything, but... Listen, I have to go. Okay, I'll tell Jared you said hi when I see him at the mall. No! Why not? I just told you. You have to keep it a secret. It's a secret relationship. No one knows. Secret. But Jared already knows you two are going out. So, what's the big deal? I'll make sure no one hears. It will be a secret between the three of us. Hello? Are you there? Debbie, are you talking about Instant Messenger? No, of course not. Listen, Lexi, I think I'm going to be able to make it tonight after all. Bab! My mom will pick you up at 6:00.